I want to show you a pretty useful function in Swift called localized standard compare. Let's see when this function can be useful. Imagine that you have an array of file names and that you want to order them. The straightforward approach would be to call the method sorted on the array. Because a string conforms to the protocol comparable, you don't even need to explicitly provide a comparison function. However, when you look at the result, it probably won't be what you were expecting. You would probably expect the file names to be ordered by ascending numbering, like the Finder app would do. But this is not what happens, and it's definitely not a bug. It's because when you compare the strings character by character, 1 does come before 2, and 2 does come before 5. In order to have a Finder-like ordering, we need a comparison function that takes into account whether a digit represents a unit, a 10, or a 100. And this is exactly what localized standard compare will achieve. This function uses the current local in order to sort an array of strings in the same way the Finder app would do. And the usefulness of this function doesn't limit to numberings. It can also be very helpful when dealing with diacritics like accents or even people's name. That's all for this video, I hope you've enjoyed it. Remember to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next one. Thank you for watching and see you next time.